We don't often hear from the prophet Micah, but in Micah 5, verse 2 that you read, we hear him talking to Bethlehem, Ephrathah. Ephrathah is that family of Jesse, the family of David that comes out of the city of Bethlehem. And so Bethlehem is this small place, and we don't usually think big things happen from small things. Like, there's garlic. I have some garlic here today. I don't really like garlic that much, especially not in big doses, but what about just a little bit? Like a small bit. If I eat a little bit of garlic, just this little piece of garlic, eat that. Ooh, it's not very good. Don't eat just a little bit of garlic. That doesn't taste very good. Well, here's another small thing. Black pepper. I don't really like black pepper either. This isn't that great, but what if I just take a little bit of black pepper on my hand and eat some of that? Oh, that's not good either. Something little can do really big things. Sometimes when you eat something little that you don't like, it can do a big thing to your mouth. God is saying, Bethlehem, you're a really small city, like maybe 300 people at this time. And yet out of you is going to come a ruler who rules over all people. God is making this promise through the prophet Micah, saying this is what the Savior is going to do. And so when Jesus comes to be born in Bethlehem, it's a big deal. He is going to be the king who rules over all of his creation, over you and me, to be Lord of our life. Let's thank God for sending Jesus for us. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you have sent Jesus in this small place, in the city of Bethlehem, to do amazingly big things for us, to be our king, so that we can be part of your kingdom. We thank you for all of his promises to us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.